We're starting at 6 a.m. with breaking news. A police chase of a possible murder suspect ending in a shooting in Escondido.
Yeah, look at this. Law enforcement's presence there. It happened early this morning right near Mission Avenue and Hickory Street. News 8's Chris Groh joining us live near the scene to explain how all of this happened. And it's still very active there. Good morning, Chris.
Good morning. It's still very much active. We're actually right here on Mission and Juniper, and right behind us is actually that scene right there. You can see multiple police officers, but what we just saw recently is that a couple of what appear to be detectives, oftentimes in those plain clothes, out of uniform, and in those unmarked cars, they just went into that scene, I want to say about 20 minutes ago. So again, that would indicate that detectives are here on scene as well, too. Now let's back up. Let's talk about that chase. It started and went across multiple cities here across the North County, and what we're being told so far is that it's believed that that person that they were chasing that you see there in that video was the suspect in a Vista murder that took place yesterday around 5 o'clock. Now, what happened though is that when they did eventually get to Escondido, where we saw those Escondido Bearcats, those SWAT vehicles also in pursuit, apparently at one point the car was stopped. The person got out, and that's when gunfire was exchanged. Now, what we saw in video is that it does appear that two people were taken to the hospital in the ambulance, which would indicate, of course, that someone or both were injured in this shooting. Now, it's not clear at this time. We have not heard from Escondido Police or the San Diego County Sheriff's Department about whether or not one of those was indeed a law enforcement officer and what agency they could be with, because so many agencies are involved so far in this chase. Now, let's show you that Vista murder scene. This took place again around 5 o'clock yesterday, and what we know so far is that shots were fired in that area. Sheriff's deputy responded to that block. It's the 1300 block of Thielen Avenue. When they arrived, they found the victim inside the home. They tried to do CPR, but unfortunately he died from his injuries. And again, the chase and the search for the suspect ensued. And now we do believe that that's what led us here, though again, we're still waiting on official confirmation. So back out here live again. We've been here at this scene for roughly about an hour now. So as soon as we do potentially get a briefing from one of the detectives that just arrived on scene, we'll be sure to let you know. But for now, we're going to send it back to you, Eric and Etta.
All right, Chris, thanks for that. And in Oceanside, a man under arrest accused of fatally shooting another man in a possible family dispute.
Police say a 20-year-old man was shot and killed about 5:30 last night. This was on Eli Street near Mission Avenue. Police later tried to pull over the driver of a car believed to be involved in that shooting. And that suspect led them on a chase, crashed into another car on Oceanside Boulevard. The 23-year-old man was arrested. No word on what led to the initial shooting. A fire is under investigation this morning after nearly causing some serious damage to a home. It started in the garage of a house on the corner of El Noche Way and Montego Drive just after 9 last night. Now, the flames gutted the garage and then spread into the attic. First responders, as you saw, they were on the roof. They had to break a hole through the roof. Thankfully, nobody was hurt in all of this, and right now, the fire is believed to be accidental. And another big story today, in fact, throughout this week, the weather.
Yeah, let's get a check on another rainy week forecast with Dana Marie. Lots of days expecting some moisture out there.
Yeah, absolutely. But right now we are waking up to 48 degree weather. And it's not too bad right now. It's a beautiful live look, what looks like over downtown San Diego. Oh, we're getting another live look there. But right now at 48 degrees, we are seeing across the county chilly temperatures waking up. I mean, 41 in Oceanside, 40 in Escondido, 48 in Chula Vista. So if you love that winter weather, it's going to stick around throughout the week. Definitely below normal average temperatures. Now for this look at our rain headlines. Rain showers start this afternoon throughout the week. It does stay. So we're going to take a look at that 8-day microclimate forecast, which shows rain a lot through the San Diego County. This is your radar where it shows right now. It's just starting to get underway up in Oceanside. As the afternoon pushes through around 2:30 this afternoon, that's when you're really going to see those heavy amounts of rain. So this red, orange, even yellow area, that means heavy rainfall going through into the afternoon in your evening commute if you're continuing work after this holiday weekend. As you can see, a lot of green on that on that forecast, which means don't let go of that rain jacket just yet. Pushing through for those wind advisories, there is a storm warning in effect, a wind advisory in the deserts, high amounts of snow expected in the mountain area, so it's good if you're heading out there to do some fun. Taking a look at your forecast highs, 35 Palomar for your high, 50 in Ramona, 41 in Julian. Now for your 8-day microcast format, coast and inland expect a lot of rain throughout the week, and then again, some chance of some snow in your mountain areas. Taking a look at traffic, looks pretty good here. A lot of green throughout the area. Doesn't look like we have any issues, but of course, we'll continue to check in. Eric?
All right, Anna Marie, thanks for that. Let's get to the latest on coronavirus here. This morning, COVID still causing problems for travelers across the U.S. as people are heading home after the holidays. More cancellations and delays are expected at U.S. airports today amid COVID-related staff shortages. Inclement weather also impacting flights, so be sure to check with your airline and monitor your flights carefully because these things change at any minute. We do have a link for you to check on your flight status. It's under the help button at CBS8.com. A cruise ship that returned to San Diego from Mexico after a COVID outbreak is once again and back out at sea. The Koningsdam first set sail last week. 21 fully vaccinated crew members then tested positive. As a result, people weren't allowed off the ship in Puerto Vallarta because of having to turn back. So yesterday, the ship took off on another 7-day cruise. Holland America says they are taking safety measures, including requiring negative COVID tests and masks for all guests. Well, today, President Joe Biden will join the White House COVID-19 response team's call with the National Governors Association to discuss his administration's response to the Omicron variant of COVID-19. Health officials are concerned about the surge in cases that are getting worse, in part because of all the traveling that's been done over the past week. John Lawrence reports.
We can tell that this Omicron is everywhere, not just, you know, something you're hearing about.
The new year will start the same way it did on January 1st, 2021, with the U.S. fighting a pandemic.
We've all really accepted that, you know, COVID is here to stay. The coronavirus is going to be endemic, meaning it's always going to be around.
The rate of daily COVID-19 cases in the U.S. from the Omicron variant surge has surpassed the numbers seen with the Delta strain this summer, according to Johns Hopkins University data.
We're doing everything we can to get people tested, and we're also trying to get everybody vaccinated because obviously that's the best thing we can do.
The number of COVID-19 hospitalizations are lower than the peaks reached earlier this year, but health and government officials say that could change.
We would like to get as many people vaccinated as possible. I think that would create herd immunity, but we have to get way over 90% of people.
And they're still stressing that those who have yet to get a shot are at a greater risk of hospitalization or worse.
The deaths from COVID right now are almost entirely preventable. Even with Omicron, if you're vaccinated and boosted, I can confidently say you will not die from this virus.
I'm John Lawrence reporting.
All right, well, you may have seen a lot of trash piling up in dumpsters, trash cans all around town, but will it ever be picked up?
Unionized sanitation workers with Republic Services are beginning a second week of their strike as contract negotiations continue. News 8's Ariana Cohen has the update.
By next week, that pile will probably be a lot bigger.
Piles of trash are overflowing dumpsters in Bankers Hill. This trash may not be picked up anytime soon.
What do we want?
Tensions have remained high since the group walked off the job, going on strike for more than a week. They say they want safer work conditions, higher pay, and improved trash trucks.
It's the fifth most dangerous job in the country, and to be doing it with such poor safety vehicles is just, that's a huge concern to all my coworkers.
You are valued, you are essential workers.
So what will it take for them to come to an agreement?
Provide a dignified wage, a good benefit, a good pension contribution. And not only that, but also dignity, respect, and the recognition that they deserve for the job that they do.
Republic Services sent a statement saying in part, quote, Republic is experiencing significant delays in collection service, but is working to resolve this as soon as possible. We apologize for the inconvenience and are doing everything to resolve this temporary situation. Until then, it could be a smelly situation.
I'm kind of shocked. It's
pretty gross.
In local neighborhoods until things change.
After Christmas, you know, folks know at home that trash piles up, but we can't do that if we don't have a fair contract to work on, if we don't have a fair contract that backs our job and that backs what we do.
Because the people united will never be divided.
Yeah.
El Pueblo Unido!
And they're still picketing as we speak right now. That was Ariana Cohen reporting, by the way. All right, the Holiday Bowl festivities officially get underway today in downtown.
Yeah, the Snapdragon Bowl Bash, they're calling this year. It starts at 5 in the Gas Lamp. It features live music, food, and free family fun. A concert benefiting Rady Children's Hospital is starting at 6 p.m. in Gallagher Square. Then tomorrow morning, the National Funding 5K run starts at 9:45 with the parade on Harbor Drive at 10. And of course, yes, there's also that big football game between UCLA and North Carolina State. Kickoff is tomorrow night at 5. Always fun to have a bowl game in your town, right? Doesn't matter the teams.
And I just want to, like, be there to see how they transformed Petco. Just
absolutely.
That alone is historic as it is.
And a lot of Bruins fans in town here, too, that hopefully be heading out there.